JBrowse is an embeddable genome browser developed and maintained by the Generic Model Organism Database Consortium. It's planned as the eventual successor to JBrowse, but both browsers will be available in FlyBase until features available in JBrowse 2 can be made available in JBrowse. You can find useful information about these genome browsers in the help documentation. This includes information not only about the browsers themselves, but also information about available tracks and a description of the differences between G and JBrowse. JBrowse can be accessed in a variety of ways. You can navigate via the Tools menu, or click on the JBrowse button at the top of the homepage, or search FlyBase for a gene and directly click on the green JBrowse button. Finally, from a gene report page, you can click on the JBrowse button next to the genomic snapshot image. The Genome Browser is split into two major sections, the Available Tracks menu on the left and the Genome Viewer on the right. The Genome Viewer has various options. There are File, View, and Help drop-down menus along the top. The File option can be used to open or add to your custom tracks or sequences. There's an option to save and share your screen as a URL on the far right. At the top, the coordinate scale has a slider that can be used to move to different regions. The region of the chromosome that is currently displayed in the detail panel is indicated with a red box. There are clickable scroll and zoom icons that you can also click and drag an empty area in the genome viewer to pan across the genome. You can use the coordinate scale of the chromosome region in the viewer to center your genome view to where you click, or select a smaller region to zoom to by clicking and dragging along the scale. The highlighter icon allows highlighting of a region of interest on the viewer. This highlighting can be removed by clicking the icon again. There's a search panel that can be used to move to a desired chromosome region. Here you can enter a symbol, FlyBase ID, or sequence location to navigate to. On the left-hand side, the Available Tracks panel can be used to select tracks you want to display on the Genome Viewer. Available tracks are organized into expandable sections. To add a new track to the Genome View, simply click on the track name. You can change the order of tracks in the display by clicking on the track title and dragging up or down. The drop-down menu on the track title also gives you various options, including pinning a track to the top of the genome browser view, saving particular track data, or changing the display mode to suit you. If you use this menu to delete a track, it also removes it from the left-hand side of available tracks. You will need to refresh the page to restore default tracks. You can remove a track by clicking X in the track label panel within the genome viewer. The gene track shows all annotated genes, including non-coding genes, with direction of transcription indicated by a small arrow. For each gene, all transcripts are shown with the complete intron and exon structure. Non-coding genes are shown in red, and blue and purple genes are on opposite strands. In the mapped mutation section, you can view transgenic insertion sites, indicated by a vertical line, or a blue box if the estimated insertion site is larger, with an arrow indicating orientation if known. Clicking on any one of these will lead to the corresponding FlyBase insertion report. The point mutations track indicates locations of single nucleotide changes, which link to the corresponding FlyBase allele report. The orthologs track adds yellow bars covering orthologous regions. Clicking on a box generates a pop-up showing drosophilid orthologs on the left and other orthologs on the right. RNAi amplicons, such as those used to generate stocks from VDRC or TRIP or NIG, can also be added as tracks.
JBrowse, why not give it a try?